Are you interested in learning how to create a subscription-based app like OnlyFans, Patreon, or Ko-fi without spending too much time or money? Maybe you have an app idea for traders, gamers, TikTok models, or unique adult audience. Well, you're in luck because I'm here to guide you through the process, share common mistakes to avoid, and provide you with some cool life hacks that will help your app generate profit from day one. Hi, I'm Dennis Babich, the director of a software development company. In this YouTube video, I'll be sharing valuable insights from my team, industry experts, and successful startup owners. So, let's dive in. Let's start by discussing the basics of an OnlyFans app and its key features. The OnlyFans ecosystem includes a mobile app, a web app, and a web admin zone. The mobile app offers features such as content posting, user chat, subscription and payment management, notification, live streams, and more. The web app has similar features to the mobile app, including content posting, user chat, subscription and payment management, notifications, live streaming, but with added functionalities within each feature. Additionally, it has more features such as analytics, content scheduling, management, and other features. In the web admin zone, you'll find a range of functions to manage your users, content, analytics, billing and payments, security settings, and user support, among others. Your next goal is to identify the crucial features and essential functionality for your minimum viable product, MVP. Releasing your product quickly is crucial, allowing you to move on to the next stage. The most important thing is to focus on 4-5 core features, add your unique idea, and develop the MVP rapidly. Speed is critical at this stage, because once customers begin paying for your product, angel investors will show a keen interest in investing in your app. Probably you know that OnlyFans have a lot of competitors, and they weren't presented on the market few years ago. But now they managed to execute the MVP iteration process correctly and outplay OnlyFans in their local niches. And you can do it too. Let's discuss pricing now. Pricing can be challenging since many people forget to include important elements like quality assurance, bug fixing, project management, maintenance, and risk management. Additionally, you need to consider the costs of developing your unique features. It's challenging to estimate the cost accurately at this point. Therefore, I'll only show you the price for core MVP functionality. Here's a helpful tip. If you require an in-house development team due to an investor contract, you can expect to pay US or EU prices. However, if you can build your app anywhere, outsourcing software development to Ukraine can help reduce cost without sacrificing quality. Many startups are already doing this. Companies like GitLab, Grammarly, Jubal, and others have recognized the value of hiring Ukrainian developers to create world-class software. With their excellent English skills, extensive outsourcing development experience, and out-of-the-box thinking, Ukrainian developers provide the best value for money. Additionally, Ukrainians are hard-working people. Now that you have an idea of the price, you may be wondering which features to include in your MVP and which ones to skip. The most important factor is your business expertise in the market and understanding how features are connected in your app. This knowledge can lead you to success or failure. In the next segment, I will teach you how to determine what's essential and what may lead you to a bankruptcy. Alright, in order to kickstart the development of your OnlyFans clone, you must firstly identify and prioritize the 10 crucial steps. Skipping any of these steps could result in failure, wasting both time and money. It's important to know that the cost of app development can vary greatly, ranging from $20,000 to over $100,000. Thus, we must carefully consider the cost differences between each type of app and determine which option makes the most sense for your specific goals and needs at this stage. Not all of these features are necessary for your subscription-based app. So, how do you determine the core functionalities? This is where a Lean Canvas business plan comes into play, helping you identify your core features and unique advantages. First, you need to identify your target audience and determine what kind of functionality they need that is not already being provided by platforms like OnlyFans or Patreon. Additionally, you should assess your potential competitors or alternative solutions that may already exist to solve the problems of your target audience. Next, consider your unfair advantage. What sets you apart from the competition and significantly increases your chances of success? Perhaps you have a large following on TikTok, which you can bring to your new app instead of paying for expensive ads, lowering your user acquisition costs. You should also think about your early adopters and where they spend their time online and figure out how to motivate them to switch to your platform. However, don't just focus on the present. Plan for the future and the potential international expansion of your OnlyFans clone, creating a vision for what your app will look like in 5 or 10 years is crucial for attracting investors and reaching unicorn status. If you have any questions, ideas, or concerns, please leave them in the comments below. I personally review all comments and I'm delighted to assist you with your questions because I enjoy helping my audience achieve their objectives. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you. Okay, if you want to create a successful startup, you need to achieve product market fit. This means thinking outside the box to create disruptive and innovative solutions for your target audience. That's why completing your value proposition table is so important. For example, you might create an OnlyFans clone for models and their audience, similar to Spotify. Users struggle with high prices for individual content subscriptions and finding the right models to follow. But imagine a platform where users can subscribe to specific model groups and receive 5 times more tailored content for only $30 per month. Users can search models by various parameters such as tattoos, weight, height, etc. Additionally, users can create a donation goal with others, and when achieved, the content creator will create the desired content. When using a value proposition canvas, identify the biggest value you can bring to your audience and highlight it. Keep in mind that small companies like yours can easily outplay big industry leaders who cannot react as fast and may not invest in your unique niche. So, don't give up and take your first steps toward success. When conducting research on your competitors, it's crucial to identify the leading companies in your industry, such as OnlyFans, Patreon, and Ko-fi. Among others, you should look for their main features and functionalities that could be useful for your own app. Do not reinvent the wheel. On top of that, an excellent tip is to investigate successful subscription-based startups in other countries and modify their concepts or methods to suit your own market. This can be a fantastic approach to discover groundbreaking solutions and stay ahead of the competition. The truth is that by following this methodology, you can outdo your competitors with ease. If you're planning to create an app or business similar to OnlyFans or Patreon, but still have some missing pieces of the puzzle, feel free to drop me a message through any of these links in the description. I'd be happy to share some niche insights with you that can be a real game changer for your startup. By using story mapping, you can effectively select the crucial features to construct your MVP quickly and prioritize functions that can be implemented and launched rapidly. Your attention should be on limited functionality with the most crucial features. However, keep in mind that you have to create a story map for each of your user types. Marketing can be straightforward. Content creators often have their own customer base and audience, so motivate them with good platform offer can bring their audience to you easily. To attract these creators, it's helpful to have a dedicated manager who can make offers and proposals directly to them. If you're able to bring in 2 to 3 market or opinion leaders, then your platform will quickly become the standard for the whole industry. If you're interested on getting more valuable insights regarding startups and businesses and wish to become a part of a community of business founders where I regularly share useful information and engage in live chats, feel free to click in the link in the video description and join my Discord channel. Once you've completed your value proposition research and identified your MVP features, it's crucial to create a wireframe map to organize your ideas and ensure that all user cases and scenarios are covered. For example, let's consider our OnlyFans-inspired app for models, which could include basic use cases, such as a list of models, subscriptions, and live streams. Missing use cases, such as what happens if a model fails to complete a task from a donation goal and wants to keep the money. By developing a wireframe map, you can ensure that your app's user experience is well designed and includes all necessary features for your target audience. If you're unsure where to start, begin by mapping out the user journey for a specific use case. From there, you can expand and refine your map as needed. UI design is an important aspect of app development that can be relatively straightforward. When examining major platforms such as OnlyFans, Patreon, and Ko-fi, you'll notice that they all feature a simple design centered around the content feed. This function is often considered the most valuable feature of subscription-based apps. Therefore, your focus should be on creating a clean and straightforward design that centers around your unique and valuable feature without any unnecessary distractions. Here's a pro tip. For inspiration on your OnlyFans app design, check out websites like Behance or Dribbble. Search for subscription-based apps and draw inspiration from the best artists by borrowing elements that you like. If you found these tips helpful, please consider subscribing to my channel and liking this video. Your support will help increase its visibility in the YouTube algorithm. When developing a software application, it's important to choose the appropriate tech stack from the beginning. This will help ensure that your app remains up to date and meets the ever-changing needs of your audience. However, choosing the wrong tech stack can lead to a variety of issues, such as difficulty switching developers, slow user interface, non-scalable and non-maintainable cloud infrastructure, high costs, payment problems, and the risk of your entire app going offline during high traffic periods. If you're creating an OnlyFans clone, it's crucial to select the right tech stack to quickly build your minimum viable product. Using Flutter or React Native will allow you to quickly create mobile apps and languages such as Python, Django, Node.js, and Amazon Web Services for your backend will help you produce your software on time. In addition, third-party services such as Stripe and Braintree for payments processing, Twilio for SMS, and SendGrid for emails will help speed up the process. However, it's important to avoid overhyped technologies that are difficult to manage, such as PHP, Ruby, and .NET. These technologies are not suitable for subscription apps and may cause more issues than they solve. If you plan to have video streaming in your app, it's recommended to use native Swift for iOS and Kotlin for Android. Frameworks such as React Native or Flutter may not be suitable for handling memory-intensive tasks such as video streaming along with controllers and chat features. Remember to choose the appropriate tech stack at each stage of your software development process. Do not go overboard at the start, but plan ahead based on your future feature set when designing your app architecture. Choosing the right tech stack is critical to your app's success, like getting a proper diagnosis after a blood test. Let's talk about the agile process. While it can increase speed, did you know that in some situations it can actually slow down a project by up to 30%? For example, a team of 5 developers who know their tasks, communicate well, and have built most of the product can have a highly effective process using simple tools like Trello, Asana, Google Docs, and short meetings. But as the team grows to 15 or more people, unexpected problems can arise. Key developers may leave the team. The onboarding process will become complex and time-consuming. Team productivity may fail. Communication issues may happen more often. Deadlines and delivery dates may be pushed out. Code and architecture quality may decrease. To avoid these issues, you'll need to hire a tech lead to manage the team and code architecture. Hire a technical project manager. Set up processes like Scrum, Sprints, Backlog, and Retrospective. Run daily stand-ups and updates on pending tasks. Use more advanced tools like Jira for management and velocity. Using the proper tools at the right time can help you achieve your MVP faster, but using the same tools without proper knowledge and expertise can lead to failure. One of the most important aspects of app development is user analytics. Understanding metrics such as unique visitors, user behavior, and common sessions is crucial for success. Utilizing tools like Google Analytics, Session Stack, Firebase, and Mixpanel can provide valuable insight into your app's performance. Consistently conducting health checks can also help identify areas that need improvement and uncover hidden client needs. Never overlook the importance of user data and analytics in your app development process. All right, if you're planning to create an app or business similar to OnlyFans or Patreon, but still have some missing pieces of the puzzle, feel free to schedule a 30-minute call with me via Calendly URL down below. I'd be happy to share some niche insights with you that can be a real game changer for your startup. See ya!